Thank you. Lead us in prayer is Pastor Hattie Kaufman. She's doing double duty today. She was also the keynote speaker for the 2014 Governor's Prayer Breakfast. The prayer will be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance, led by Paige Jill Swanson of Pukwana.
Please join me in prayer. Eternal God, we thank you for the men and women you have called to be leaders in this community. Thank you for their willingness to step into the fray. Thank you for their hearts of service. God, we especially lift up those in this chamber. We ask your blessing upon these leaders. Give them wisdom, guide their steps, protect and encourage them. And Lord, we also pray for their families who are sacrificing that they can be here during this legislative session. And Father, we ask your blessing upon all of those who are at work in this building, from the governor's office to judicial chambers, legislative staff members, secretaries, janitors, and yes, pages, all of them we ask your blessing upon, and we ask that you help to remind all of us that to be servers, that to lead is to serve. Give us servants' hearts. Remove any self-seeking. God, grant us peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
Clerk will call the roll.
Representative Anderson, Bartling, Beal, Bolin, Bordeaux, Bruner, Campbell, Consett, Craig, Cronin, Deutsch, DeSanto, Dryden, Duvall, Feichert, Gibson, Gosch, Greenfield, Hager, Harrison, Haugard, Hawks, Holly, Heineman, Hickey, Holmes, Hunhoff, Hunt, Jensen, Johns, Kaiser, Killer, Kirschman, Klum, Langer, Latterall, Marty, May, McCleary, Mickelson, Munsterman, Nordstrup, Otten, Partridge, Peterson, Qualm, Rasmussen, Ring, Romkema, Rounds, Rosum, Russell, Schaefer, Schoenbeck, Shanefish, Shrimp, Sly, Soli, Solem, Stalzer, Stevens, Tolson, Vershiel, Werner, Westra, Wick, Willidson, Woolman, Zickman, Speaker Wink.
Here.
Mr. Speaker, a quorum is present.
Approval of the journal.
Mr. Speaker, the Committee on Legislative Procedure respectfully reports that the Chief Clerk of the House has had under consideration the House Journal of the seventh day. All errors, typographical or otherwise, are duly marked in the temporary journal for correction, and we hereby move the adoption of the report. Respectfully submitted, Dean Wink, Chair.
Those in favor of approving the journal signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay. Journal is approved. Reports of standing committees.
The Committee on State Affairs respectfully reports that House Bill 1051 do pass, House Bill 1029 do pass as amended. Brian Gosch, Chair. The Committee on Appropriations respectfully reports that House Bill 1021, 1022, 1042, 1049, and 1060 do pass. House Bill 1057 do pass as amended. Justin Cronin, Chair. The Committee on Judiciary respectfully reports that House Bill 1063 do pass, House Bill 1061 and 1062 do pass and be placed on the consent calendar. G. Mark Mickelson, Chair. The Committee on Commerce respectfully reports that House Bill 1037 do pass, House Bill 1033, 1034, and 1038 do pass and be placed on the consent calendar. House Bill 1027 do pass as amended. Tim Rounds, Chair.
Messages.
Mr. Speaker, I have the honor to transmit herewith Senate Bills 19, 32, 36, 61, and 68, which have passed the Senate, and your favorable consideration is respectfully requested. Respectfully, Kay Johnson, Secretary.
At this time, we're going to have, we're at the end of our first page cycle. They are each here for 2 weeks, and so they will be going back to their schools at the end of the day. And so we're going to have a little ceremony where I've asked Representative Jim Boland to come up and read a resolution. After the reading of the resolution, the pages will come by when their name is called one by one. And then at the end of that, we will have a vote on the adoption of this resolution. So, Representative Boland.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. A resolution expressing the appreciation and gratitude of the House of Representatives of the 90th Legislature of the State of South Dakota to the following pages. Whereas the above named served loyally as pages for the House of Representatives of the 90th Legislative Session, and whereas the members of the 90th House of Representatives expressed their most sincere appreciation to these young people for their service to the state, and whereas the members extend to these young people their wishes for every success in life, now therefore be it resolved by the House of Representatives of the 90th Legislature of the State of South Dakota that a personal copy of this resolution be duly certified and furnished to each page on his last day, on this, their last day of service. Adopted by the House of Representatives, January 23rd, 2015. Dean Wink, Speaker, Arlene Kvislin, Chief Clerk of the House. The following individuals should be prepared to receive their certificate.
Representative Boland, would the House Majority Leader please come up, and the House Minority Leader please come up.
I'll be reading your name in alphabetical order. Your name's in alphabetical order. Haley Block, Emily Driesen, Taylor Gajkowski, Robert Hagar, Peyton Heitkamp, Marty Larson, Austin Lynch, Morgan Nelson, Marley Scarborough, Latricia Schindler, Hattie Seaton, Jill Swanson, Riker Vosberg, Megan Wallman. Let's stand and give each of these fine individuals a round of applause.
Thank you, Representative, and thank you, Pages. I hope it was a good experience for you. You made new friends and learned lots about how state government really works. So carry the message back to your home high schools, and hopefully some of your classmates will come next year.
Representative Boland moves that the House Page Resolution 1 be adopted.
Those in favor of the Boland motion signify by saying aye. Those opposed, nay. Motion carries.
Representative Gosch moves that HCR 1001 be deferred to Monday, January 26th, the 9th legislative day.
This is a voice vote. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay. Motion carries. You want that back?
House Concurrent Resolution 1002, supporting the continued operation of the D.C. Booth Historical National Fish Hatchery. The Speaker has waived the committee referral. Representative Gosch moves that the temporary House rules of the 89th legislative session be made the permanent House rules of the 90th legislative session.
This is a roll call vote. So before the body is the adoption of the Gosch motion to adopt the temporary House rules to be the permanent House rules. So those in favor will vote yay, those opposed nay. The clerk will unlock the voting machine and the members will proceed to vote. While you're voting, we're still having problems with our mics and with our timers and so on, and they're going to work on that over the weekend. Please bear with us on this.
Representative Hickey.
Representative Hickey, have you voted?
Representative Hickey. Mr. Speaker, all members present have voted.
Clerk will please display the vote.
Mr. Speaker, there are 66 yeas, 1 nay, 3 excused.
Gosch motion having received a majority of the vote of the members elect is hereby adopted. Consideration of reports of select committees.
Representative Gosch moves that the reports of the standing committees on Health and Human Services on House Bill 1013 and the report on transportation on House Bill 1020 be adopted.
This will also be a roll call vote. So those in favor will vote yay, those opposed nay. The clerk will unlock the voting machine. Okay. Excuse me, voice vote. Those all in favor of the adopting the Gosch motion, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay. It is adopted. Consideration reports by the Joint Select Committees.
Representative Gosch moves that the report of the Joint Select Committee relative to the joint rules for the 90th legislative session be adopted.
Okay, this will be a roll call vote. Okay, those in favor will vote yay, those opposed nay. The clerk will unlock the voting machine and the members will proceed to vote. Our doctor of the day here is Dr. Mary Milroy from Yankton. She's a general surgeon who specializes in breast surgery. She received her MD from the University of South Dakota School of Medicine. Completed a general surgery residence at Michigan State University. Dr. Milroy has practiced Yankton Medical Clinic since 1991. Dr. Milroy, are you in the... Thank you. She's standing up here in the back. Thank you very much. We also have students from the St. Joseph Indian School. I think we have the seventh graders here. And Mr. Matt Monin is with them, and they represent Representative Schaefer's district. Let's welcome the students from St. Joseph Indian School.
Representative Russell.
Russell votes aye.
When the pages were coming through, I know there are some family members from some of the pages. Would they please stand at this time? Go ahead, stand. Thank you very much for letting your kids come.
Mr. Speaker, all members present have voted.
The clerk will please display the vote.
Mr. Speaker, there are 67 yeas, 3 excused.
That motion has been approved. Okay. First reading of House bills.
House Bill 1076, an act to permit the submission of a title insurance policy in lieu
of an abstract. For you students from the Indian School, this is probably looks a little confusing to you. Our Constitution, Article 3, Section 17, requires that we read every bill twice. Because before we had computers, they wanted to make sure that they had a chance to read the bill before they voted on it. So they read them all at the same time, and this will serve as our first reading.
House Bill 1087, an act to authorize trust protectors to be a party of a legal action to remove trustees or pursue legal action for and on behalf of trusts.
Speaker assigns House Bill 1084, 1085, 1088 to Commerce, House Bill 1077 to Education, House Bill 1079 and 1080 to Health and Human Services, House Bills 1076, 1082, 1083, and 1087 to Judiciary, House Bill 1081 to Local Government, House Bill 1078 and 1086 to State Affairs. First reading of the Senate bills.
Senate Bill 19, an act to revise certain provisions regarding references to the Internal Revenue Code. Senate Bill 32, an act to revise certain provisions regarding veterans' preference for all veterans who are United States citizens who seek employment with the state, a county, or a municipality.
The Speaker has assigned Senate Bill 61 to Health and Human Services, Senate Bills 32, 36, and 68 to State Affairs, Senate Bill 19 to Taxation. Second reading of consent calendar bills.
House Bill 1016, an act to revise certain provisions regarding references for auditing standards used by the Department of Revenue. House Bill 1017, an act to repeal certain outdated and unnecessary provisions related to the Department of Revenue. House Bill 1019, an act to revise certain provisions regarding exemptions from sales and use taxation of farm machinery, attachment units, and irrigation equipment used exclusively for agricultural purposes. House Bill 1031, an act to repeal certain provisions regarding former state-owned rail lines.
Consent calendar bills, having had their second reading, are now up for final passage. Those in favor will vote. Are there any questions first before we vote? Are there any questions on the consent calendar bills? Seeing none, the question before the House is final passage of bills on the consent calendar. Those in favor vote yea, those opposed nay. The clerk will unlock the voting machine and the members will proceed to vote.
Rosen votes aye. Representative Stalzer. Mr. Speaker, all members present have voted.
The clerk will please display the vote.
Mr. Speaker, there are 67 yeas, 3 excused.
Okay. Motion carries. Second reading of House bills and joint resolutions.
Representative Gosch moves that the balance of the calendar, including House Bill 1018, 1012, and Senate Bill 28, be deferred to Monday, January 26th, the 9th legislative day.
Second. Those in favor of the Gosch motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay.
Two.
Motion carries. Announcements?
Mr. Speaker.
Yes, Representative Jensen.
House and Senate Joint Committee on Appropriations will meet at 7:30 a.m. on Monday morning.
Thank you very much. More announcements? Representative Boland.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Again, a reminder, Monday, 3:30, after session on Monday, we will have a Retirement Law Committee meeting. We'll have a presentation about the retirement system. It's going to start at 3:30 or 15 minutes afterwards if we get long-winded that day. You can learn about the retirement system, investment council, all those things. We will, at the conclusion of that presentation, be handling 5 bills. So we encourage you to come. This may be our only committee meeting the session. So come learn about the retirement system Monday, 3:30, 4:12. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative. Representative Sly.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. House Education, 7:45 Monday morning. We'll be here starting our first bills.
Thank you. Representative Rounds.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Monday morning, we usually meet for House Commerce Committee, but I'm giving you folks in Commerce Committee the day off. So there will be no Commerce on Monday. We will get back to it on Wednesday. Thank you.
Very kind of you, Representative. Any more announcements? Representative Mickelson. Did everybody hear him? One more time, Representative. You need help with that, Representative? Representative May, can you help Representative Mickelson?
Mr. Speaker.
Yes, Representative Jensen.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I think he was trying to say House Judiciary will meet 10 a.m. on Monday. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Representative Jensen. Any other announcements? Representative Anderson.
Mr. Speaker, I move
adjourn. Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, nay.
No.
Ooh, speaker's in doubt. Does everybody have their motel reservations over the weekend? We'll try this again. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay.
No.
No, we're adjourned.